the like button now.
Hit the like button. If you're in the chat, hit the like button.
Hit the like button. Hit the like button. Hit that like button. Like.
What's that mention on my ear? Perhaps the end is drawing near. And never hear the shot that takes you down.
Out of time, so say goodbye. What is yours now is mine. And I dream broken dreams. I make them come true. I'll make them for you. It's out of nowhere.
This is not good news. What's up, wrestling fans? The thing that I fear the most happened. Now, obviously, earlier today, the one thing I will say that I wish I covered more earlier today is I wish I did give him more. I wish I discredited this a little bit more. But, you know, the very thing that made this seem legitimate is the very thing that makes me think we should have discussed more the possibility of how this could not be legitimate earlier today. Because here's the thing. Andrew Zarian does not break a lot of news stories. You know, it's only once in a very blue moon that Andrew Zarian breaks any wrestling news. I think him to be a good person, so therefore I don't think he legitimately went out to, like, falsify something to get attention for his channel or whatever. I don't think that's what happened. I don't think he's that type of guy, to be honest. So I believe, you know, that he... But it was weird to hear something from him earlier. Maybe someone threw him under the bus. I don't know. But what I do know is I can't tweet him. So normally I would... See, the problem is normally I would tweet him and, like, ask him certain things, but I am still banned on Twitter for another 4 days. So therefore, you know, but then again, Andrew is friends with the scam artist himself, the Fightful people, and Sean Cyclops, Creeps on Women. So these people, I suppose if they're in the same boat together, which they are, they make up news stories for whatever they do. So maybe, you know, but Andrew, to my knowledge, has always been a good guy. So I would, you just don't hear news stories break from him a lot. So this was suspect in the fact that he's not usually somebody that breaks stories like this. So that should have been the first kind of sign that, oh, I don't know about this. But I really put him over earlier. I didn't say anything about, oh, you know, I'm worried about this. And, you know, you got to take this with a grain of salt. You know, I think everybody was pretty certain. I mean, major wrestling podcasters and major wrestling news outlets, I mean, people believed this report, you know, for one way or the other. So it could be true still that this is still happening, but that it's not necessarily happening this Monday. Or maybe it was going to happen. Or it's a fake story to sell Patreon. You know, I mean, they've got how many Patreon people? So it could be a fake story to sell Patreon. You know? I mean, guys, when it comes down to it, I mean, they have a lot of patrons. You know what I mean? And they put out a Patreon post about this. So they could be, do they have 6,000 patrons on Fightful? Did you know that? 6,000 patrons on Fightful. You guys think Sean Ross needs your help anymore? You think Fightful still needs your help? 6,700 patrons. Dude, Fightful makes $33,000 a month on Patreon. They make $33,000, allegedly and roughly. I don't know 100% on that, but it's pretty close. Somewhere between $28,000 and $50,000 a month. And I'm guessing $33,000. They make $33,000 a month on Fightful with these type of stories. That's a $500,000 a year. So I don't make near that. So I give them credit for that. Their hustle game is pretty good. Because I have 180 patrons. I have 180 patrons. They have 6,765. Which could explain why I, you know, can't function on YouTube much anymore. You know, they are doing a lot better. I guess I need to get a female who just looks like Denise Alvedo. I don't know what I got to do. You know, get my eyes to grow closer together. I'm not sure. But I don't think that I think this is just bad luck, or maybe Andrew did jump the gun a little bit, but maybe he had some wishy-washy news report. But you know, it looks like, I mean, it could still be happening, but I will say that really time is going to tell on this one. If they never go TV-14 in the next 2 months, you know, I think he's going to be blamed for this. You know, people are going to remember, but if they go TV-14 in the next 2 months, the worst thing is that people will say, oh, you know, Andrew, you know, he didn't know the exact date. He got the date wrong. He got the facts on the date wrong, or, you know, whatever. Somebody changed their mind at WWE, and it's not really his fault. He just, you know, he tried to report on what he heard about. So, but, yeah, this is rough. You know? This is a blow, man. We started the day fired up and excited, and now this is this is a punch to the gut. I gotta be honest. Even if it is gonna happen still, but not for a while or whatever. Like, I was getting excited for Monday. I mean, maybe they found out I was coming back and they were like, nope, never mind. Go back to that again. I'm just kidding. I love making it all about me. It's funny, but obviously it has nothing to do with me. But yeah, maybe we can catch Fightful at 6,000 patrons if you guys all become a patron tonight. You know. We would need about 100, 200 patrons, and we can start trying to catch up to Fightful's Patreon. Maybe. We'll see. I'm going to be going over to Discord in a minute. Asher's over there. I don't know what's up with Mustafa. I don't know.
I talked to him yesterday and was like, yeah, I'm definitely doing out of nowhere, but I don't know. He did message me like an hour ago. He tweeted me and him, like tweeted, so something must have come up with him. Usually I start out of nowhere at 11 though, so maybe that's what happened. I'm not sure. He might be on his way too. He might be coming. Yeah, I've done a podcast with Bahati, with Bill Body Bahati. I always fuck up his name with Billy there. But yeah, we're nowhere near it. You know what I mean? That's why I don't do a lot of news reporting. You know, listen, news reporting is a risky business. You know, you gotta fake stuff, you gotta pretend stuff, you gotta be grimy, you gotta actually get in with people and know things, and then you gotta spin a whole bunch of shit too. And you really have to politic a lot and things like that. And I just don't like that, really. So that's why I don't do the news reporting stuff. If people have stuff, they do bring it to me, and you guys know that I talk about it. I bring it up if that's the case. Like most recently with the Scarlett Boudreaux thing and, you know, Karrion Kross, I believe that report is probably right, that they were afraid of Mark Marrowing him or something, and that's why they seemingly held off. That makes the most sense to me out of anything I've heard. Plans change, yeah, they certainly do. But again, like I said, Andrew does not use, I think he's a good guy. I think he's a good person and a good guy. So this is something I believe he definitely believed. He would not do this unless he had some kind of actual word about it. Now let's go to what he said. This is a wild situation. There's a lot going on behind the scenes. WWE Raw won't be going TV-14 on July 18th, but still in consideration for a later date. So this is, maybe it is just to sell his deal. There was a memo within USA Network that went around this morning regarding WWE Raw changing TV-14 on July 18th. Apparently that was sent out prematurely and the day was not finalized. So this could mean that they are going TV-14, but there's no exact date on when that's going to happen. So again, maybe that's what's happening. That's what he says is happening now, if you want to believe it. But that's also a pretty big tease, and then it's like, well, I'll see you tomorrow on my show. You know, what? So that is the one little kind of like, you know, red flag that pops up to me. You know? That's a little bizarre, huh?
Shit bum!
Oh my god. Oh my god, I'm donating to Joe.
Oh my god.
Leah, wake up. I can't believe this is real. Joe, you and me, Boston Common Street Fight.
Beating
you over the head with a sandwich.
The Goon! Wow, the Goon. What's up, Goon? Holy shit. What up, Goon? I would love to meet somebody at the Boston Common for a fight at this point. At this point, the only thing that can happen that's good is I can get my head bashed in and killed, and then I can no longer exist on this planet. But my kids won't have a dad, so that kind of sucks. But I'm kind of game otherwise, you know. Hey, man, Goon, I appreciate it, bro. Thank you so much. Really appreciate that. But what a weird day, you know. I mean, one minute, oh, we got this great thing. It's gonna be amazing when WWE goes TV-14. Oh wait, they're not going TV-14. I don't believe it. I'm shocked. I am. You know, I think it still could happen. I just don't want to give. You know what I mean? I don't want to play into this. You know, just in case this is some kind of a weird grab for attention by Fightful people, because these are Fightful guys. Let's be honest, right? They're all about money, right? Fightful is all about money. You know what? I'm starting to spin. I'm starting to wonder if this is a big thing where Sean Cyclops was like,
dude, Sean Ross crap.
Sean Ross crap was like, you know what? Andrew, you say this. I don't want to say it because it's wrong. But you say it and then plug our Patreon everywhere. You know, so maybe it was a screw job and they just want money. I mean, they're making around $33,000 a year. I mean, a month on bullshit on Patreon. You know, it's not like they're doing different shows like I used to do, Corrupted and all these other things. They're just doing wrestling news behind a paywall. So maybe they're just selling
the
Patreon.
I think about it.
What's that?
I think that Monday Night Raw will be going TV 14 this Monday, and I think that he said, you know, all this to backtrack just so he could get people to, you know, think, oh, no, there's more news going on. Let me, you know, donate $5 to their Patreon to get some more insider news before anybody else can and see if when the actual date will be. I still think it'll either be this Monday or next Monday. Pretty obvious.
Maybe, but I don't know. He's the only source that said this, and everybody ran with it because he doesn't usually report.
I mean, even Alvarez did it too, didn't he?
Well, I mean, yeah, I mean, everyone jumped on. Well, okay, when did Alvarez report it, though? He reported on the report of Andrew, though, right? I never saw anybody credit Alvarez. I only saw Andrew getting credited all day from everybody. I mean, Andrew, like I said, Andrew Zarian is a good guy. Like, I've never known him to be bad. Even with him knowing that Sean Ross Sapp, like, hates me, and he knows that I'm not even sure, dude. I don't really hate anybody. I got to be honest. I really, in real life, don't really hate anybody. It seems like Sean Ross Sapp is a scumbag and that he's a shithead. He seems like that, but maybe he's not. Maybe he isn't like that. And he's a little douchey, but so aren't all of us who are on, like, I'm douchey, you know, it's like, so maybe we're all just douchey to each other and I have no idea. But in real life, you know, if I met the guy and, but you know what it is, when I apologize to someone, and I really apologize to somebody, like I apologize to Sean Ross Sapp because he was saying that, like, oh, you know, I'm the one starting all this weird shit and I'm not, you know what I mean? And then I said to him, hey, listen, man, people play all the sides and stuff like that. You know, let's just whatever. But he never responded. You know, I tried to say, like, I'm sorry in an email, and I said, hey, man, I'm sorry that happened. And I said, whatever, and I don't think these things, and I'm not doing this, you know, this is other, you know, whatever. But, you know, he doesn't even say back anything. It's kind of like, all right. And then other people tell me about things he does. So it's just like, I'm left to believe, like, this guy kind of sucks. Because if he sent me an email and was like, listen, Joe, I think I might have gotten you wrong. I think I was wrong about you, maybe, and I'm just confused with what people say, and I don't really know you, and you don't really know me. I'm cool with you, bro. Let's just move on, and you're good, man. Let's come on the show sometime. I'll go on your show or whatever. We'll talk off the air, whatever you want to do, man. I hope you have a good day, and, you know, you're cool with me now. I mean, that's basically what I sent him in an email. He didn't respond to my email, though. He just was like, I'll be a bigger dickhead. So then I'm a bigger dickhead. So I'm being a bigger dickhead. So, but to me,
he thinks he's too good for his own britches. It's that ego of his making
maybe
that moolah every month.
And listen, I still see him as somebody who was small. Like back in the day, I used to do live reviews and he would put out videos with only 200 views and shit like that. And he wouldn't even do many videos. And it's like, I saw him as like a, all right, whatever, you know, and now it's like he's way bigger, but I still feel the same way I do now back then. You know, I don't have any different look on anybody. But I could be wrong. But again, Andrew to me, though, has always been seemingly a good person. Like, that guy's always been a good guy, in my opinion. So I have no reason to ever disbelieve Andrew Zarian because he comes off to me as honest, or maybe he's better at politicking. I don't know. But I know I've known him off the air several times. I've had conversations with him. He's always been good. He's never comes out with, he doesn't usually put out a bunch of stories. You know what I mean? Things like that. He doesn't do that. But yeah, I don't know. I don't know. I don't know what it is. Sean Ross.
Another big thing was Brian Alvarez tweeted 5 hours ago, plans change, period. That's it.
Yeah, that's all he said.
That's all he said.
They do. They do. They do change. But you know what? If new wrestling news is dead and I need some clicks on my website, I could call up some of my journalist friends and we could say that we heard about a memo thing that happened, even though it didn't. So plans change, but people also bullshit. So
yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, I agree, plans change, but I think people bullshit and I don't know what's true, but I do. Something is fishy though. For Zarian to be the one to put this out there is weird. So that either means like it was definitely true or like what, or like someone played him or something. I don't know. Very strange, though. I will say that. Very strange.
Either 100% correct or 100% false, and there's like no in the middle.
Well, but that's the thing, is it could be in the middle, right? Because it could be, oh, you know, they're thinking about going TV 14, or it's going to happen soon, and but for some reason there was.
But that's what confuses me, is because he, you know, broke the news so early in the day. I mean, you even had a chance to, you know, do a midday stream. And then just later in the day, just the news breaks. It's just, oh, by the way, guys, I might have been wrong. And just leaves it there. Yeah. Like, what are you supposed to do with that information?
Yeah, it's very, like, Meltzer. You know, that's what, like, I don't...
Yeah.
Like, that's the thing, is, like, it's weird, dude. It's a suspect thing. But again, like, I don't know what to make of it. Again, it's coming from a guy who usually... I don't know. It doesn't seemingly lie to me, but then again, like I said, he's part of Fightful and he's part of their Patreon and making money, you know, and maybe he's a good politicker, you know, maybe Andrew is a good politicking guy. So people get things wrong. I just think that it's bad. It sucks for Andrew if this is the case, because he was out there solo by himself. Basically out there on his own putting out this information, and for this to be wrong or change or whatever, it sucks for him, because now everyone's looking at it like, what? Who is this guy? You know? And
yeah.
I don't know. But most people are familiar with him, even if they don't like him or watch him that much, because he's very dry, you know, very serious in his wrestling takes and dry. But again, I don't know, man. I've always known him to be a very nice guy. Like I if I had to sleep over someone's house, or somebody was like, I need a place to stay, like, I'm not worried about this guy. You don't really know him and he doesn't really know me still. I mean, but we kind of know each other, but I trust this guy a lot more than Cyclops, you know. Cyclops would probably
what's the chick's name? Denise Salad Woman?
Denise Salad Potato. She fucking sucks.
Yeah.
Bro, does she suck or what? She just comes on and goes, hey, and smiles.
You all have decided to take your hard-earned money and to fund my show, to fund what I
tribal
do,
chief.
To fund what I believe in, to fund
the ghost from the coast.
Godly ass. Ooh. JCS Army.
Wait, that's not the right donation.
Donate to me.
Wow.
I can't see it. What is it?
Well, it's the Roman one, but it's the wrong thing. You'll see in a minute. I'll fix it.
Acknowledge me. You got to acknowledge me.
Oh, 51.
Yeah, big 51.
So the TV 14 was misinformation? But let's be honest, Joey, even if it did go to that rating, it wouldn't matter until Vince died.
Oh, man. It might be true. The ghost from the coast with a huge tip. Let me see if I can get the right dono to play for you, Ghost. I put it up on Super Chats, but I didn't put it up, I guess, on...
What's the $51 one?
Well, it's the alien one.
Oh,
it's Mr. Alien. All right, let's play it the right way. Let's get it the right way. We gotta get this right.
It's been a while since I've heard some of the other donations.
And what did he say? Let me make sure I hear what he said while we do this. Oh, the ghost from the coast. I don't think I don't know, man. All right, I'm gonna put up a poll and see what you guys think in a second. Let's see what you guys think. And while I put the poll up, let's play that again, baby. Oh, shit, Joe Bishop, thank you, man. Joe Bishop has become a member once again, and that is sick, man. Joe, thank you so much, my friend.
There's something there going it is. On up in space. There's something going on up in this place. There's something weird kinda happening, strange kinda happening, things are kinda happening. What the fuck is happening? Aliens. Extraterrestrials, they gave me a shot. Nanotechnology. I'm not me. You're not you.
I'm not you.
I'm fucking crazy. crazy split personality, Scott McKinnon.
So the TV 14 was misinformation? But let's be honest, Joey, even if it did go to that rating, it wouldn't matter until Vince died.
Oh, man. Well, let's
Jesus, that's harsh.
Let's hope that doesn't, that's not what it is, you know, because we need, I think we need Vince, man. I think we need Vince. Okay, so I got, Ghost, thank you so much for the $51, man. Holy shit, bro. Let's go. We need a nice alien. Wait, where's the, we need to find the gif of him pouring the beer down his gullet. So is Andrew's report fake? Yes, it's fake. He lied. It could have just changed. It will still happen. It will happen someday. All right, so I put a poll out to find out what you guys think about this. Big poll up there for you. Ghost from the Coast dropping a huge $51 donation. Ghost from the Coast. What's up, Cockblower? Oh, he's gone.
He left right.
Right as I called him Cockblower. Well, listen.
I'll be honest with you.
I'll be honest. I'm kind of retarded. Ghost from the Coast, big time donor.
Sounds a lot like Andrew Zarian.
Yeah, it's kind of, sounds a lot like Andrew. Sounds like Andrew. You know what? I bet you this is a conspiracy. I bet Sean Ross Sapp fed this to Andrew to discredit him more, so that he seems so much more right. So, don't you think that could be what it is?
There's a possibility.
You know, so he's sending him fake info, so that.
Has really given me an idea.
What's that?
So one day I thought, you know, make a fake account, like on Twitter, whatever, you know, some social media, and message like one of the whatever Sean Ross crap does, and, you know, give them like fake insider news and see if they actually report it. Right. See what the odds are that they actually report, you know, just some random thing that they send, because that, you know,
well,
I see so much crap every day. I think that.
Well, before, the problem with that is before they would believe that I am a source in the company, I'd have to get some things right, you know, to be like,
yeah.
So they'd be like, oh yeah, okay, this is someone in the company, and they're not telling me who they are, but they got that really right. So, okay, next time they leak something or whatever, you know, so there has to be some kind of, you know, establishment there. They're not gonna exactly risk, I don't think, anything. Meow meow the heel. Became a member again. Yo, meow meow. Thank you. He is a 9 months in a row. Drop kick that like button. Meow. He says he's got more cats than JD, but his cats are in good physical condition. JD's
but
are
keep up that sneaker game.
JD's are penetrated. Yeah, keep up the sneaker game. Please don't cease and desist me again. Oh, SRS sent it to Andrew because Andrew is smashing Denise and SRS is jelly. That's probably what it is, dude. He's a fucking weird person. He's looking for pussy everywhere, that guy.
Yeah, he is.
It's dude, an office affair.
It's so obvious, dude. He's the next one to get Me Too'd or whatever the fuck you call it. I can't wait till it happens.
What has Meltzer been saying about it? Is my what I've been wondering.
I don't know. Only Alvarez has said anything. Meltzer's probably, yeah. You know what Meltzer's doing? Is he's thinking about how to create a story about how he knows what's going on. So
he's probably wondering, how am I going to clean up my trashy office with paper flung all over the room? Right. How about you clean your office, you dumb wannabe freaking journalist?
Well, you know what? Ask me right now. Pretend I'm Meltzer. I'm gonna do what Meltzer does. Now, pretend I'm Meltzer and ask me what's going on with this situation. Go ahead. Ask me.
What's going on with the situation, Mr. Dave Meltzer?
Well, guys, here's the thing. So we have to understand what's happening. You have to really go back to how these things start, right? So there's a meeting. You know, they've been talking about this for years, right? And they've been wondering what to do. And recently there was a meeting, and it was suggested, once again, this comes up a lot, that, you know, they want to go TV-14. What would happen if we went TV-14? And eventually what happened was it was fairly split in the back, is the rumor, is what I'm hearing, is it's split in the back. Vince doesn't really want to do it, and everybody else is split. So when they sit down, you know, if Vince was on board, it would happen. You know, if Vince was on board with it, it would absolutely happen. But they're split, and Vince doesn't really know about TV 14 right now. He doesn't really want to do it. So because of that, you know, it's just kind of been sitting around like stalemate or stagnant. But recently they decided, you know, hey, let's do it. And what happened was they then changed their minds. But as things happen at WWE a lot, a memo had already been generated weeks before to remind everybody, you know, in production that this was a TV 14 program. But, you know, this was weeks late or weeks earlier that they decided not to go through with it, or at least not yet. So the memo goes out, you know, and that's how the news comes out. And so today it gets reported on that they're going TV 14 on July 18th. But, you know, that memo has already been scrapped by the company, and everybody still knows over at WWE that they're not going TV 14 yet. So now we really don't know, you know, how far away it could be, but it does look like they're going in that direction, but we just don't have a timetable right now. And that's the thing with, you know, when sometimes people get news, they only get a part of it. And this was one of those cases, you know, but it's until Vince McMahon says yes, you know, it won't happen. Oh, wow. Dave Meltzer, so smart. Holy shit.
Mr. Meltzer, how did you yet say so much, yet so little information?
Exactly. That's exactly what he would swear to God. That was right down the pike of what he would what he would do. I could do a show on this stuff. Kyle Palace Dave, man. Kyle Palace Dave is an OG, and he says he's a piece of shit. He goes, acknowledge your world champion Golden State Warriors, baby.
Oh, God.
How many, you know what? How many Golden State Warriors championships? Five? Let me know when you got the 18. It's the 17 the Celtics have.
Yeah.
Sorry, yeah. Even though you beat us.
The Warriors can kiss my ass.
J-Rod can't even fucking get
kiss the Warriors.
Oh, man. So anyway, our hopes and dreams have been crushed. WWE not going TV 14, it looks like.
Listen, you son of a bitch.
At least not right now. I think they should sign Alex Jones.
Oh, my God.
Can you
imagine Alex Jones as a commentator in professional sports?
If they ever sign Alex Jones, that bet I can the Powerball.
Oh, my God. Can you imagine
him? The establishment says, Kambuga shaka munda, kunga kingo, booga laka, booga blah, 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 blah.
They'll turn that into racism somehow. You know what I'm going to do? I want to tell you exactly what my client Brock Lesnar is going to do. He's going to eat your asshole live on WWE pay-per-view. Have you ever... Well, we're not...
They're putting paralegals in the office. They're returning the freaking McMahons into an affair.
They're putting goddamn paralegals in the office. Do you understand what they're doing? They've got a camera in every bathroom in Stanford. All right, and I knew this was going to happen because I was at the shareholders meeting one day, and they thought it was going to go down already because there was Vince McMahon's chair was moved away, and I was like, man, what are you doing? Why have you moved Vince McMahon's chair away from the desk? And then Vince came in, and I saw the look on most of their faces. They were like, what the hell? Oh, like, and they realized they were a week off. It's not happening until next week. And so I knew right there, man, something is weird. And I said, Vince, they tried to move your chair earlier. I've never seen anybody touch Vince McMahon's chair. And they brought it back like, oh, sorry, Mr. McMahon, we were cleaning the chair. I don't buy that. I don't buy it. They're putting paralegals in the goddamn office.
I don't like them putting chemicals in the water that turn the freaking frogs gay.
That's pretty funny. Ashley, that was pretty funny. Alex Froelich, thanks for subbing to the channel, man. What's going on? Good to have you here. Appreciate it. Thanks for subbing. Yeah, I don't know. I find it hard to believe that he would lie. But, you know, he is part of the slimy weirdos, you know, over there. But he's a good person from what I know. Thank you, Alex, from how I've known him. Biggie says he would be at peace even if he was in a wheelchair. He was like, hey, if I had been in a wheelchair because of this, I'd be at peace because I'm ready to, you know, deal with whatever life gives me or whatever. I was like, wow, okay.
Oh, God.
He may not wrestle again now. Like, they're worried that he could end up being in a similar situation.
Dude, I was at the show that he broke his neck at in Birmingham.
Really?
It did not look good.
No. Uh-huh. I mean, we got a clear shot of that. He did not look right.
I was on the floor seats, too. I was like 12 rows behind commentary. I got a good view of that. It was not good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was...
Too bad they're not breaking him up on New Day. I think he would be much better on his own.
Well, he was just, you know, in the middle of his attempted solo run that really didn't end up going where we thought it would go. And
at least he got a world title run out of it, and even an intercontinental title run, too.
I don't know what he's going to do now, but at least luckily he's, you know, he could end up being one of those type of guys too that's like a GM or somebody. But it's like, dude, he's still way too young. I mean, he should be wrestling another 10 years.
I mean, he's still able to, you know, there's a chance for him to wrestle because I saw something, you know, the timetable for him to return is next March.
Yeah, no. He could still wrestle again. I think he is going to wrestle. I don't think he's that bad off, but... I don't know, bro. It's just scary. It sucks that. Well,
I mean, Jason Jordan and Tyson Kidd, you know, broke their necks pretty young and they become agents.
Yep, they were done.
Yeah.
And Big E's gotten a long. Even though Big E's young, it's like he's had a long career now compared to.
Yeah.
I mean, what are we on here with Big E?
I mean, think about his NXT days. I mean, that was what, 2013?
Yeah. 2012? Or 12. I think 12. There. Yeah, because
He debuted on the main roster in 2013 as a part of Ziggler's
whatever. He's been doing this for 11, 12 years.
Yep. 12 years.
Jeez.
12 years in WWE. Wow. Almost 10 years on the main roster. I mean, that's
dude,
a,
that
that's a
NXT
long
run where he had where they had to do the five count was pretty cool, though.
Yeah, if you
three ain't enough, man, I need five.
To put it in perspective, I believe Shawn Michaels and Marty Jannetty arrived in WWE as the Rockers around WrestleMania 5, I think it was, or 4. It was either 5 or 4. I don't remember which one, but you know, so if you take 10, add 10 years to that, it's WrestleMania 15. Well, Shawn Michaels didn't wrestle at WrestleMania 15 because he was out. So it's the first half of Shawn Michaels' career, which I knew him mostly as a kid, you know, his tag team career and his singles heel career and his first championship run and, you know, ending at WrestleMania 14 when he finally left. I mean, dude, that was, you know, that was 10 years right there, you know? Yeah. So Shawn ended up coming back and then doing another, you know, whatever. What did he come back and did another 10-year run? Yeah. So he came back for another 10-year run. You know, unfortunately, Big E could do another 10 years right now, another 15, 10 years. But... Now, you know, with the neck thing, I don't know. I mean,
what kind of surgery he had?
What kind of surgery did he have? Is that what you said?
Yeah.
I mean, I don't think
he didn't get surgery. I think Big E said that his doctor said surgery is off the table and it's just physical therapy. And he's going back in a couple months to go get it checked out. I think he said.
Have you seen Sasha Banks' asking price for her personal appearances?
Much is it?
Well, so she's out of WWE, I guess, right? So she is out, but they haven't said anything, which is, I believe that's them not wanting to promote her. Because normally they love to say, future endeavor, breaking news, they're gone. But now they're back to hushing and not telling you when someone's gone, I guess.
They probably don't want to bring her name up anymore.
You raised a piece of shit!
Exactly.
Screw TV 14 and bring on NC-17.
I agree.
I bet Big E has a big D. Wins on a pole match.
What's up, everybody? It's me, Big E, and I got the big D! Imagine that if he came out and said, I'm Big E with the big D. Dude, that would get over. That would get over, I'm telling you. Yeah. Big E, what's up, everybody? It's Big E with the big
funny
D. Oh.
Well, Drew McIntyre's already got the Big D gimmick.
Oh, does he?
Remember the New Day bought him that little underwear that said Big D on it?
Oh.
What?
Well, but he didn't promote. He didn't have the mic skills to put that over, so. This will be different. This will be like, he'll really be ready to go here, you know?
Thank you, Jinder Mahal's back acne.
But no, allegedly, according to Fightful, $30,000. $30,000.
Whoa, you're kidding.
Well,
for one time.
Yeah, you want her at your birthday party? Dude, I'll tell you what. If I was a rich person, I'd pay to wrestle her.
I'd pay her just to come over so I can kick her out of my house.
That what the dude? Man. That's a great idea. Come on in, and now, hey, get the fuck out of here!
Yeah.
And then just yell at her and have her be like, "What are you doing? You're a dickhead."
Just like call the cops on her and say, "Like this woman, she broke into my house. She's trying to steal everything."
and then yell, "She's not white!" And go viral for being
our cousin
racist.
Snoop Dogg. She's got a lot of money. I'm going to sue her for everything she's got.
Oh, my God.
Oh, man.
just try to go viral for being a racist white person. And then like, there's people picketing outside your house. And you're like, no, man, it was just a joke. It was a joke. I was pretending to be this, like, bigot guy. It was part of a skit. Fuck you, racist! And you're like, no, it was a skit.
Oh, Alex Jones and Sasha. Alex Jones and Sasha.
Oh, my God. Do you know what Sasha Banks is capable of? I swear to God, if anybody comes up to her at the airport, I will eat your asshole out.
Listen, you son of a bitch.
Jesus Christ. God. I love Sasha, though. I went to, you know, when I was leaving wrestling school, again, she was just started her training when I was leaving a place. For a little bit, and I'm telling you, man, I saw her there and was like, I love this lady. I don't know, man, who the fuck is this girl? You know, she was much younger then, but it was like, and then I watched her on the indies, and I was like, I've always liked her in the ring. You know, yeah. I like her in the ring. She is light and very small and stuff like that. But
yeah.
You know, but I've liked her. I like her. I just miss the NXT Sasha. I wish when she Mercedes Indies Sasha is great, yeah. But I miss the Sasha Banks NXT where she's like fucking just a bitch and she was seeming, but she also seemed awesome.
Who was that little kid that was that Bayley supporter that was like crying in the crowd and she like ripped her sign up in half?
Yeah. Yeah, now that girl is all over everything.
I miss
WWE.
That Sasha. Yeah, she's annoying.
Bro, Sasha Banks is...
Izzy?
Yes, Izzy, yeah. When Sasha Banks used to come out, dude, that's what... Again, I still to this day have never bought another woman's t-shirt. That is the only t-shirt I've ever owned. It's Sasha Banks's.
That was awesome.
Oh boy, just look at some of these
NXT
entrances.
Sasha was great.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, she had it's the swagger that she had and the vibe she had. She doesn't have that and has never been able to really have it much. On the main roster, because they shortcut her all the time. They cut her fucking reins short. They fuck with her every time. It's so weird what they do to her. Let's see a Sasha. Do I have a... Maybe. Oh, here's one from 2015. Oh, this is her versus Becky Lynch. This is her versus Becky. This is live from the crowd. This vibe right here with her. This is great.
No, that's her old theme, too.
This is Unstoppable Takeover 2015.
And throwbacks. Dude, I missed that NXT.
Yeah, this was awesome, man, back when NXT was... I mean...
When it was ran in... where was it? Full Sail.
And you know what? To be honest, AEW put them out of business. Everybody always talks about what went wrong. And, you know, if AEW never came around, I don't think Vince would have taken over with his bullshit.
I think it'd still be black and gold, yeah. I think the pandemic kind of hurt it, too.
Yes, that's true. Right? She's just a great, great entrance, great look, the confidence, the championship. It felt like the real champion was there and someone needed to beat her. And when Bayley, you know, beat her, I mean, bro, that's one of... I'm dead serious about this. I'm dead.
Shit bomb.
This is the best women's rivalry.
NXT Asuka greater than NXT Sasha. Asuka was untouchable in NXT.
Yeah,
Asuka's
I mean,
undefeated streak was awesome.
Yeah. Yeah, Asuka was a face though too, right? Wasn't she face? I don't remember.
I can't really remember to be specific. Well, I know when she debuted on the main roster, she was, and somehow like they let Charlotte beat her undefeated streak because they carried it on from NXT onto the main roster, and like she broke it at WrestleMania by tap out. How do you break a upcoming star's momentum by tap out at WrestleMania after winning the Rumble?
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know, man. I don't know.
Vince should kill himself.
I eat my own asshole. Trans Paul says FAW. Brokick, what up? NXT was great. All the takeovers back then, yeah. I mean, NXT had like, what, 20-something takeovers that we all loved for the most part up until the end here. But, yeah, so the TV-14.
You know, the last original black and gold NXT takeover with crowds was NXT TakeOver Portland. And that was the right before the Elimination Chamber.
That was the one where
That
was the one where Antifa jumped the guardrail.
Yeah, about to save up.
No, I'm kidding. No, when was that? When was that, Asher? I don't remember.
It was the main event was Adam Cole versus Tommaso Ciampa for the NXT title. That was also the one that had that really, really good match with Keith Lee and Dominik Dijakovic for the NXT North American Championship. But that's the last full arena black and gold NXT takeover.
Yeah, probably right.
Also had Balor, Gargano, Ripley, Belair, the Broserweights. I forgot Matt Riddle and Pete Dunne were a tag team, and they beat the Undisputed Era.
Oh, really?
Yeah, if AEW wasn't around, they was to be going.
Man, I miss old NXT.
Speaking of Matt Riddle, the one thing I want to see from the TV-14 rating is Matt Riddle smoking a blunt in the middle of the ring.
Oh, God. What is RVD?
Hey, bro. Hey, Randy. You want to smoke this with me, bro?
I can't even imagine.
You want to smoke my pole with me, man?
Oh, Jesus.
I'm sorry. But no,
to have like the Street Profits can actually come out and, you know, actually drink what's in their cups instead of having like an actual empty cup.
They should have stuff in there. They should have a little crack
or water or something.
Yeah, just give them a little crack in there. It's okay. It's all good.
Let's just have some water.
Doesn't need any more crack.
Let's just have wings.
Let's just have wings.
Let's just have wings.
But no, so back real quickly just to roll around again. TV-14, the report, Andrew Zarian, gonna happen Monday night, TV-14. Now that is not true, allegedly, according to him. So he reported that was the news. Now reporting that's not the news. That, the memo said that, but now things change, and we don't know when they're gonna do it, but they've been talking about it, but it's probably not happening this Monday. So that's weird. Everybody kind of reported on the report. I think it was a slow news day, maybe. I don't know. I don't know if that's why Andrew is with Sean Ross Sapp on Fightful, so that Andrew can report things that are probably, we don't know if they're true or if it's part of a gimmick of theirs to get more subs or to pretend news. I don't know. But I do know that Andrew always seems like a good person, and I don't think he would purposely... I don't think he would purposely lie about this stuff, but then again, you never know, man. When it comes to money, who knows what people will do? Hell, if Sean Ross called me up and said, Joe, can you leak out this stuff? Because I don't know, whatever, and I'll give you, $1,000. I mean, maybe I would do it too. It's just a stupid story. So I don't know what to tell you, but, fuck it. I don't know, bro.
So why don't you just not review Raw until it goes TV-14?
Well, I guess I'm going to go back to that.
Sean Ross Sapp and Andrew Zarian found out that you were bringing back the Raw return, and they're like, nope, this actually isn't going to happen.
Yes, just put it off one more week so Joe Cronin stays off the air. Oh my God. Yeah, I mean, I was saying last Monday night, I'm quitting Raw reviews, I'm done. And then they announced it's TV-14, and I said, oh, fuck, I'm back. I'm not leaving. All right, well, let's go. And now it's, we don't know. So it's very confusing.
What do you mean quitting? I didn't say anything about quitting.
I didn't say anything about goddamn quitting. You know, Andrew Zarian works for Wrestling Observer. Well, I don't think that that's true, because let me explain why that's not true. Why he doesn't just work for Wrestling Observer. He works for Fightful as well. Andrew Zarian has Sean Ross Sapp's Patreon pinned to his Twitter.
Oh, yeah.
Why would Andrew Zarian have Sean Ross Sapp's Patreon that has 6,700 patrons on it? Why would they be making about $35,000 a month on Patreon? And why wouldn't he pin Wrestling Observer here? So what the fuck is going on?
Yeah, he definitely works with Fightful.
Yeah. So he works for Wrestling Observer, but he works for Fightful too in some way. They pay him money to put up their Patreon at the top of his pin or something like that. Or he reports the stories that are wishy-washy so that Sean Cyclops doesn't get in trouble for it. Something like that. Yeah. Something's up. I don't know what it is, but I'm not stupid.
On a tweet that Sean Ross Crappuccino retweeted of Andrew Zarian, he said, "I can confirm there were mixed signals given internally about this." Someone replied saying, "Was it announced or leaked?" And Sean Ross says it was leaked. So what does he mean by leak? Was it leaked in the office? Was it leaked to Zarian? Was it and what does he mean by leak? Like, was it not supposed to happen then?
It's a slow news day. That's what it is. It's a slow news day. Yeah, nothing was going on. Yeah.
And if it does become true,
they just make stuff up. I mean, come on.
It'll probably happen after SummerSlam.
I mean, maybe. I think I'm starting to go with, I think it's all bullshit. None of this was ever true ever. Yeah. That's what I'm starting. I really do.
There's
believe
a possibility.
It. I really believe it's none of this was ever true, and somebody told people bullshit and they jumped the gun or whatever. It's something. That's all it is. We're never going to see PG. Because it was shocking. Remember, we were like, what?
Yeah.
Like, it didn't make any sense. So now it does make sense. It's called Too Good to Be True, and we all believed it. Everybody did. Everybody reported on this today. Everybody.
Because wrestling fans are desperate for something new, and not the same old raw bullshit that Vince and Bruce Pritchard and that keep fondling each other over.
Yeah. Or they wanted
to... It's been nonstop bad news.
Or they wanted to see, or this was a test. Sometimes they do leak out fake bullshit.
You raised a piece of shit!
If I had $30,000, I would give Scarlett Bordeaux 29 grand and give Sasha 20 bucks in gas money to buy me $980 worth of wooings.
Zach Gowen sucks at punting.
You know, I know something sad, Zach Gowen? Look at the WWE trend. This didn't even help them.
You raised a piece of shit.
Joe Cronin, must watch my last two posts now. Live to the Joe Cronin Nation.
Woo.
Acknowledge the Wrestle Daily.
Ladies
Cheers,
and gentlemen.
Botch Club.
Please follow Botch Club on Instagram. It's unbelievable. But also make sure you follow the Wrestle Daily. As I talked about them last night, they're so good. The last two posts on Botch Club. Let's go take a look and see what he's talking about.
Take a look. Have a seat. My name's Chris Hansen.
Let's just take a look.
Have a seat.
My name's Chris Hansen. I'm a liar. Botch Club. Although he did some good work though at one point. Let's see what he's got here. Oh my God.
Take your face off. It's about drive. It's about power. We stay hungry. We devour. Put in the work. Put in the hours. And take what's ours. Like in some morning in my veins. My culture banging with strange. I change the game. So what's my motherfucking name? What they gonna get though? Desecration. Defamation. If you wanna bring it to the masses. Face to face. Now we escalating. When I have to put boost to asses. Mean on ya. Like a dream. When I'm rumbling. You're gonna scream mama. So bring drama to the King Brahma. Punch with extreme mana.
Thank you, Brother Tech Nine. Thank you, Terramana. One take. That's a wrap.
It was like take 50. That was so cringy.
Take a bump.
The Botch Club has so many good things. Here's some more. Assaulted mankind with a... Oh my God, dude. Watch this.
It's Kane busting down the door with an axe, and it's amazing. Michael Scott.
Do a little basketball dance off time.
Oh my God, dude.
I'll be honest, I'd like to take a big bite out of your taste.
Ollie Davis from WrestleTalk said you're a disgrace to the wrestling industry and that if he sees you in person, he would deal with you. I've heard him threaten you lots of times. He's also told his viewers to flag your channel on his Patreon stream.
No, he hasn't.
Ollie Davis can suck a fat little corn on the cob.
I don't believe that, Joker.
Eat your tea and crumpets. Sit with your freaking perverted friend that works for your company that had to leave what culture because he likes messing with women that's freaking sexually harassing people. Keep hiring people and not do proper background checks.
Jesus. Hey, listen, if you actually provided me with clips of him saying those things, I would love to see that, but I doubt he said that. I really don't think, because as much as I make fun of like Ollie Davis, I don't think he's a
really poly.
I've never known him to be a bad guy. He seems like a nice person. Now, if that's true though, and he really has said those things, that's actually bizarre. Like, but I doubt that that's real. I doubt he said that. I joke around about, I don't like the way he speaks. Like, I don't like his videos, the way he speaks, but you know, cause it's I find it annoying, but I think the guy seems like a nice guy. But if you tell me that he's actually saying things like that, I'm something or whatever. Hey man, send me those clips. I'd love to see that. Cause then I will destroy his fucking ass. But no, from what I can tell, he seems like a sweet heart of a guy. I don't know, but maybe I'm wrong.
That king. Assaulted mankind with
a... We gotta watch this again. This is really funny.
Like the king assaulted mankind with a...
I know I'm sexy. I've got the look.
Dude, that's... Oh my God, dude. Oh, and that's why you should subscribe on follow Botch Club on Instagram, because that shit is fucking hilarious. 38,900 followers. They're almost at 39,000. Help them get there. That's funny. It's me, it's Ollie Davis, and we got the WrestleTalk news, and we're going to tell you about the new WWE World Champion, and I talk like this. I don't know. But no, I joke about him, but I don't say anything that bad about that guy, because I don't know. They seem all right.
Yeah, it seems nice.
But yeah, maybe not. What if they... Imagine if he really was... I actually think it would be really exciting to find out that if he wasn't. Like, if we actually did find out that he was this crazy scumbag person saying terrible things about me all the time... Oh, that would be so fun. Like, it would be so fun to just destroy. But
Which one are we talking about again? Because there's a bunch of British people.
Well, Ollie Davis. I don't think so, though. I think he would. I don't think he gets into that type of shit. You know, I think he's seemingly a good guy.
I know Sean Ross Sam blocked me for trying to get you on their show.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he ended up blocking me because I was defending you.
Yeah. No?
So I'm not going to say it. Like Grimm, Sean Ross Sam hates autistic people.
He does. Well, listen, Grimm actually does hate autistic people, but he doesn't hate me. So, like, you know, I get along with Grimm, but he does have a problem with autistics. So I'm sorry about that.
He follows me on Twitter, so he obviously doesn't have a problem with me.
Listen, he doesn't know if that's the case. Yeah, the second he finds out, like, you're done. You know, so just...
I mean, didn't he find that out about Tommy? He was like, no, I don't want him on the show. I don't want him on.
Yeah, he was like, I'll wrestle you and everything. Then he found out, he's like, oh, you're kind of retarded.
Because, I mean, like, I remember that Monetize This where you and Ken were hiding in that freaking hotel room and everybody in the chat was like, he's showing up on GTS Wrestling. And you guys were like, no, I don't know what you're talking about. And then you guys showed up and, like, all this stuff about Tommy came out. And I remember Tommy getting so pissed off.
Dude, remember then Tommy was, like, sucking Grimm's dick?
Dude, I remember.
And yeah, just that's the difference between me and Tommy. I don't suck Grimm's dick.
Yeah, no. Tommy lied about. I played this on the show because Tommy was like, "Oh, I love you, Grimm. And I was like, I thought you said this guy was a piece of shit or whatever. And then Tommy was like, I never said that, you liar. Anyway, let's take a look at it right now.
I saw Tommy was trying to, like, awesome to see you there. Cool, man. I hope in the future to meet you both again. I couldn't believe it. But then, and then Tommy, and then so I wrote that. I said, you already met Grimm, and you said he was a pile of shit who hates autists. You said that. And Tommy said that back in like 2017 or 18 or whatever year it was. Then he even repeated it over the years. And then Tommy flips out and says that I'm a liar. Like I'm always called a liar, that I make things up.
You know, Grimm, I was a little flustered because I feel like you never wanted to collaborate with me, but I never said you were a piece of shit.
You toy show, you piece of shit.
I never said you were a piece of shit.
Get it off.
You show, you piece of shit.
With a fucking chair. You're afraid
that I could kick your ass in the ring. I could.
You're goddamn
but you're
right.
Afraid of my autism. Yeah, and you're afraid of shit in this community.
No, you're afraid of my autism. That's the best part.
The autistic thing to say is you're afraid of my autism. Step in the ring with me, Grimm.
You're afraid of my autism. Oh my God!
Don't want to step in the ring.
I'm sure it probably does. Yeah, you know what? I actually had I had Grimm's toy show ready to come on the show. He was going to do a whole thing with me and Tommy, and then Tommy backed out of it and said, or Tommy said, I won't come on your show with Grimm. And then Tommy did? He reached out to other people and told them that he would do the show with Grimm and someone else and other people.
Oh.
And
you know what they say, Tommy's so fake.
Yes, he's so fake, dude. Me and Grimm had an understanding because Grimm came to me and he goes, Joe, as long as it's on your show, I will sit down with Tommy and we'll have like a big thing.
The thing is Grimm's a great dude too.
Exactly. Even Grimm knows. Like people came to Grimm for like whatever. He goes, hey Joe, all these people are just trying to take the it was Grimm's idea to do the thing on my show. And so then Grimm said, Joe, all these people are trying to get me to do this now, but on someone else's show and somewhere else. And he goes, what the fuck is going on? So he goes, all right, well, fuck this. We're not doing it. And I said, okay, Joe, sounds good.
Wait, Joe, wasn't I the vote? Given that Tommy backed out, wasn't I the vote to replace Tommy?
Yes, you were the vote to replace him. But at the time, I think it was like WrestleMania week, and Grimm was like really busy, so we didn't end up doing it. But he was.
I'm still ready to go if he wants to get his bad New Jersey ass.
Yeah, you should get.
Well, no,
I
would love to do both of you. Like, and maybe he could pick his favorite autistic person between the two of you. That would be exciting. Yeah, it might be you. Let's hear more of this.
I could kick your ass in the ring. I could.
You're goddamn
right. But you're
right.
Afraid of my autism, and you're afraid of shit in this community.
Where's he
no
looking off to the side to?
If you bodies,
it's an autistic thing, Pete. They really do that.
Slam me in the fucking ring because I have a disability. You know what it is?
Mm-hmm.
Not the fact that I have autism.
Open your eyes, Tommy.
You're a piece of shit.
Yeah.
And you wouldn't even show the action figures I gave you in your vlog. At all, the fact that I gave you after Heel Life took your action figures away from you, even though that's a gimmick, and I brought you action figures, and you were so scared of me when we were at Wrestling Darlings, and I walked right up to you and gave you wrestling figures, and I wanted to do a good promo with you, and I actually
think she's Tony.
Come up in your backyard, and I want to come up and meet you.
Oh yeah, remember that clip? Come up in your backyard.
And I wanted to do a good promo with you, and I actually come up in your backyard. And I want to come up and meet you, and you won't fucking respond to me on Twitter, and you're like, hi! You know? Fuck you, Grimm. Fuck you, and everything, all your fucking action figures. I reached out to you to collab, and you fucking act like a bitch.
But right there, Tommy tried to have a Boston accent like me. Did you hear that? You fucking acted like, listen.
I noticed that.
Yeah, he tried to do a Boston accent. Listen.
I feel like Tommy was trying to appropriate my culture.
Yes, he's trying to appropriate our Boston accent.
And you fucking act like a bitch.
Why don't you go out for some hangings, you fucking North Carolina piece of shit?
Oh. Then he said,
stay in Asheville.
So there he goes again, calling him a bitch again. He called him a bitch multiple times. So it was just...
And Joe, you always had to run your mouth, and this makes me not want to come back to your show. Ooh. This makes me not want to work with you. This makes me not trust you. So,
haven't seen you in hasn't been here in like 3 years. Like, oh no, you know what? No one trusts
hasn't
you.
Hasn't been relevant in 10.
You know what? I was actually Tommy's friend, and he left because of we don't know why. So he actually is the non-trustworthy one. And he's lying right here about me. So actually, Tommy is the untrustworthy one. That's the funny thing. But, you know, the truth hurts. You are the untrustworthy one.
Running your mouth. Because that's all you do is run your mouth. Okay? So
no, I told the truth, and now you're running your mouth.
Shut up, Joe. Just shut up. Stop running your mouth, and you doing this kind of shit is not going to make me want to come back to your show.
I'm not going to let you on my show.
So, piss off.
Fucking your girlfriend or what?
Well, no, I mean, at least
he's afraid of me.
Because I feel like you never wanted to collaborate with me, but I never said you were a piece of shit.
Wow, toy show.
Why does he say piece?
I never said you.
It's called. Hey, listen. He has a high school diploma. I don't. So, you know, I mean, he knows more than I do.
Yeah, but at least you're not retarded.
Actually, by law, I am considered retarded.
Wait, by law, you're considered retarded?
Yeah, autism is protected under the federal government. So,
really?
Like, if someone were to assault me, they would be committing a federal crime.
Wait a minute, you can assault regular people, but if you assault the autistic person, it's worse?
Yeah.
The hell's the difference?
What?
I never. Well, one has a developmental disability, so it's more of a it's treated as like you're like you assault like someone that's over retirement age.
I could see if like you stole a wallet, like you like it would be a federal offense. Like it's a federal offense if I go up to someone and go, "Hey, Sammy." Hey, man, what's going on? And then I was like, hey, yeah, listen, dude, you're going to have to give me $20 right now because otherwise some bad shit's going to happen to you, dude, because that's what I heard that. Oh, you heard that? That's all I have left, but all right, well, I better do that. Here you go, it's $20. See, that to me, that's a federal crime. You just lied to some guy who has autism. Like, I feel like that's taking advantage of someone's mental capacity. Yeah. Like, and so that to me is a federal crime. But just punching someone in the face who's autistic or punching someone in the face randomly who's not autistic, how the fuck, like, what? That doesn't make it, like, punching anybody should be the same crime.
Yeah, I agree, but under federal law, someone hitting me is worse than someone hitting you.
That's awesome.
I was watching a couple of old monetized, this is around, like, 125 area that... And Tommy was like saying, I would never ask anybody for money. I never asked Joe for any money. And then like JB and Ken were talking about like, you know, just making fun of him. And then literally a couple episodes later, JB plays a recording of Tommy asking him for $150 for this new thing that he wanted on Tommy's show.
It was a mask. He wanted the mask. That was the mask thing.
Oh, buy me the mask. Oh, that's what it was.
Yes, you mark for this show.
Shut up.
You
fucking mark. Fire me.
You fucking mark. I don't even. Why isn't that? I went to play that. Dude, that just froze my soundboard. I went to play the mark.
I froze your soundboard.
I went to play the MJF mark. What happened to it? Why did it holy fuck, dude, my soundboard froze. Is it going to fix itself?
Oh, there
you
fucking mark!
There it goes.
There it goes.
We miss you, MJF. Please come back, MJF. Please!
You fucking mark!
Tony's doing.
Take it away.
Come on the Joe Cronin show.
Take it away, Ric Flair.
There's 9,000 people that are going to stand up and say, fuck Ric Flair.
You damn right, son.
I don't know what Tony's doing, though.
Oh boy. Let's go through the chat and see if there's anything else here that I'm people are asking that I'm missing on here. Let's see. MJF level pipe bombs. If Grimm could get a girl, so can you. I don't know if he's talking about Asher. I mean, Grimm had two girls, but he downgraded. His old girl lost more weight and got hotter. And then he kind of like, he downgraded, you know, let's just be honest.
I mean, that's what you get for making money playing with toys on the internet.
Yep.
Go back to your truck driving business.
If you're still playing with toys when you're 45, your wife is going to leave you, you know? And unfortunately, you know, It's interesting because Grimm, so I don't know, well, I don't want to talk about it, actually. I don't want to talk about his personal life, but I mean, he's back in
the
original.
He's too good of a guy.
No, he's a great guy, and he's back in his old house. And I feel the same way for him I felt about Onision. And maybe I see myself in these guys' situations, so I worry about me, so I worry about them. But, like, Onision lost that mansion he had. Onision had a fucking mansion. And, you know, Grimm had a big house. But then, you know, when his wife left him, he had to move back into his old house. But I think they own that house. So he's in a small house again, but at least he owns it. You know, I think he outright owns it. I'm not sure. And, you know, Onision had to move into a house that's even smaller than the house that I'm in right now after he lived in a fucking mansion because he fucked over the IRS for, like, $300,000 or something, worse than me. And so, you know, I feel bad for people to lose. I want people to do well. You know, I don't want people to lose shit. But when YouTube went south in 2020, I mean, you know, Grimm's, all our numbers are down. Yeah. You know, everybody's numbers for the most part are down. So I, you know, I hope it gets better for everybody on on YouTube. But if not, we were lucky to have this time we had. Alex Oli says, Oli Davis is the male version of Denise. Oh. Yeah, I guess you're right. He just has a lot of energy but says nothing really. So it's like, okay. It's like I could sit here and report the news.
Sound like he's on cocaine.
Because he probably is. You know? He's out there in the UK on cocaine. I don't think he hates me, though. I think that guy was just trying to cause shit. You know what I mean? Like, he was trying to get me to...
I think he's under the influence of Sean Roth Jackass.
It could be true. Yeah, because you know what? I go
Ross
to...
Frappuccino.
Let me... Where's the...
I raised a piece of shit!
I have made fun of them,
is
though.
2023 finally the year that Katie Vick gets in Hall of Fame? Hell, that soul glow-wearing bird-rapist Coco Beware is in.
Only if we see her puss-puss. Okay? But you know what I can say is I'm
be boned by now.
Isn't Sapphire in there too?
Ooh, sweet Sapphire. I mean, dude, even Oli Davis's fucking Twitter picture is like, why does he look like that?
Huh. Oh my god!
What is this, dude? Why are
it
you?
It looks like he's about to go touch your children.
Hey, Joe, you know how you say I look like a school shooter? That looks like a school shooter.
I'm here to date your six-year-old.
Oh, my God. Bro, he's... I mean, we've got Kevin Dunn level teeth going on here, Oli.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know why he wants to look like that. I don't know. I mean, but then again, you know, there's, you know...
Hoping it's satire.
Well, no, I know it is. I know he's being goofy. I mean, but look at me. I make funny, weird faces, too, you know, like where I'm like, hey. So maybe that... But it's like he looks just like he always acts in his videos, where he's like, it's like, what are you doing? I don't know.
He's about...
I mean, okay, so let's just compare it. I mean, like, let's be not be a hypocrite. Like, look at this. You know, like, I mean, this is a fucking weird face. Yeah.
I think it's a classic.
Yeah,
it's a classic,
but it's
but
not
funny one.
It's again, it's very similar to like how retarded he looks. You know, maybe there's just a thing with retards like me and Oli Davis, where we want to.
Well, I mean, he's also British, so of course he's going to look retarded.
I'm pretty British too. I mean, really think about it. I mean, mine looks more like I'm on crack and ready to fucking go crazy, but I think his is more like I'm
hiding in an alley.
Like I've got turds in my fingernails.
Oh, I hate those kind of people.
Right.
Doo-doo stank breath and doo-doo under their fingernails.
Yeah.
He hired Adam.
Probably
so.
A child or two in their basement.
I don't know. I don't look very good either, though, I will say. I don't, you know.
I mean, Joe, the dude hired Adam Blompier.
Yep.
Yeah.
And he didn't get any of the, or maybe he did get the puss. Oh.
Who knows?
Well, you know, I will say I don't know. His eyebrows are gigantic, though. I will say that.
Yeah.
But I like him, though. I mean, as a person, he seems like a nice guy, but I could be wrong. And he doesn't have me blocked or anything. So I think that guy was just making stuff up.
Yeah.
Because
and then all of that stuff that Blompier does on their sister channel, whatever it's called, Parts Funknown, some good content.
Well,
although Blompier is a weird guy, but it's still good.
Only good stuff on that channel with the fucking booking videos, and those have gone down in quality.
Adam's bending the knee to the woke idiots, like, who got mad because he talked women about sex. Like, that made me, I lost a lot of respect for him. That guy might sell his own mother for a dollar if the woke mob came for him. You know what I mean?
He's going to do whatever he can to make himself look better in the list. At least he acknowledges what he did was wrong, but I mean, come on, move on, dude.
Yeah, I don't look very, I look fucking creepy here. So, you know.
You look like you just took, like, snorted a line and just took a picture and said, "Hey, Leah, take a picture."
You know what it was? Is I was making that face and I realized how insane I looked and I thought that was funny. I'm like, why? Wow, I look like a maniac. So I made that a picture. Like,
I
was like,
I wonder how many thumbnails you have with that picture on there.
Probably a lot. Yeah. It looks like some crazy crack is going down there, you know, at that point. All right, listen, I'm going to head out, man. I'm going to wrap it up. I said I'd do an hour tonight. Wow. Well, I mean, I said I'd do an hour. I mean, unless there's something else. It's an hour and 20 minutes in. I don't think there's really much else I wanted to talk about. Is there anything else that you
A lot of good clips from this one, though.
Yeah, a lot of clits.
I guess we were fine.
Oh.
Hey, man. I'll see you tomorrow night, monetize this. I'll see you guys then.
All right.
All right, Friday night, monetize this. Get wet. Get scared. All right, I did an hour. I did my promised I'd do an hour. I did an hour. And I don't know what happened with Rostoff again. Maybe I fucking get scared away. But, I mean, this is basically it. Coming back to re-go over what we found out about here, which is crazy. You know what I mean? This is weird. TV 14 not happening now. Crazy. Why?
Once the metronome I hear, perhaps the end is drawing near. You never hear a shot that takes you down. Out of time, so say goodbye. What is yours now is mine.
See you guys tomorrow night. I'll see you Friday night for Monetize This live right here. Tomorrow night, baby, 10 p.m. Be here. And I want you to be on crack cocaine. You got it, pal? Okay, Joe Biden, I want you all to be here Friday night. And we're all going to have some woo wings, baby. Woo wings.
Woo wings.
Courtesy of Ric Flair.
There's 9,000 people are going to stand up and say, fuck Ric Flair.
Now become a patron on patreon.com/JoeCroninShow. Patreon.com/JoeCroninShow. Thanks to everybody who donated tonight. Braun Breaker of Hymns. Whoa. Thank you, the Joker Botch Club and the Wrestle Daily on Instagram. Please follow them on Instagram. Zach Gowen sucks at punting. Alex Oli, Jinder Mahal, Cal Palace Dave, Meow the Heel, Joe Bishop, the Ghost from the Coast, dropping a $51 Alien Man donation. Eat my fucking balls. Hey, you guys are the best. Please click that like button on the way out. And if you're still watching this on replay, feel free to try to give a super thanks down below. And if you want to, contribute to the show if you like. If not, then I'll see you in hell. See you guys tomorrow. Shout out to Zombie13 on YouTube. 12,000 subs. He's almost at 13,000 subs. Give him a sub. Zombie13, the best wrestling covers you've ever heard. Trust me, he's a good guy. I know I said trust me about Andrew Zarian yesterday, or this morning, and now apparently he was wrong, but still. Seems like a good guy. I say when I think people are good people, I tell you. Hit that like button.
There's 9,000 people that are going to stand up and say, fuck Ric Flair.
You know what? I fucking came in a bowl and your mother drank cum soup for me.
Oh my God!
Yo, Joe Cronin lives rent-free in a whole bunch of motherfuckers' heads. Leave me alone. Leave me alone.
If I'm not talking about him, yo, he says that I am. If I won't respond to his dumb lies, the shit he can't stand, why would I do 3 hours like he does to me? Kinda shit is pathetic. That's why I'm living rent-free.
It's cause I'm living rent-free in your fucking head. If I was a nightmare, wouldn't up there, words are like swords straight into your head. The fatter that they are, the more that they bleed red. Cause I'm living rent free inside of your head. If I was a nightmare, you fucking wouldn't up there, words are like swords straight into your head. The fatter that they are, the more that they bleed red. You better fake that before you say something dumb, and I ain't playing around. And yo, your wife is a cunt, yeah. You brought mine up first, eye for an eye, and yours is fatter since birth. And she got fatty thighs.
And it's been over a year. You would think he'd move on, but he's hot for my nuts. Dreams of sucking my schlong. He will not give up. Says I'm a bad dad, but I take care of 3 kids. Yo, he's projecting, it's sad. His family life must be tough if he's projecting so much. Time to finally speak up against his fat fuck.
Because I'm living rent-free inside your head. If I was a nightmare, you fucking wouldn't up there. Words are like swords straight into your head. The fatter that they are, the more that they bleed red. You better fake dead before you say something dumb, and I ain't playing around. And yo, your wife is a cunt.
Never ends. Spend your whole life desperate for love. You'll build any narrative to be completely beloved. For what you have, you thank God, but you ain't godly at all. You stab a friend in the back if it puts you up on the top.
Living rent free inside of your head.
always have wings.
You always think of me.
You raised a piece of shit. You raised a piece of shit.
Oh!
Weirdo.
Come on out, you rapist!
There's 9,000 people that are gonna stand up and say, "Fuck Ric Flair and
you fucking mark!"